Well, they're finally out, and most of you lucky guys who managed to get your name on one of the 200 limited run first editions should hopefully have yours by now. Here is mine, and it's time to take a closer look. Hello and welcome to AAR On Air. Today it's the promised look at the official production line CLX First Edition from BSA. I've been really looking forward to this because the one I tested and reviewed at the launch was a 2.2 caliber and it performed really well. But I do prefer to get my hands on a 177 for testing. Mainly because I only test by punching holes in paper rather than any form of pest control. And I do love the accuracy and flatter trajectory of a 177 caliber. Hence, this first edition, which is indeed my 177. There are a few twists to this review over the initial launch programme, both from BSA and from my preferred input as well. So, without further ado, let's start this, as always, with the walk around, shall we? Now, this first edition is clad in a beautiful, rich walnut stock, a finish that changes in differing lighting conditions. And as always, I love the fact that every wooden stock is different and has its own individuality. After all, it's a natural material. You know, it never fails to amaze me when people complain about the coloration or shade in a wooden stock. I swear that they expect it to be some sort of clone finish. Maybe we're all too clinical these days, or so acclimatised to plastics and man-made materials. I do love the lighter and darker shades to this stock, and I love the way it complements the black of the metalwork beautifully. Then there is the gold or brass finish to the filler port and the bleed of that into this form of golden ring at the front. The stock is truly ambidextrous and has a comfortable stippled grip and forestock. There is a cutaway around the newly designed safety that is a doddle to move into fire or safe by simply using your thumb. And this cutaway can also be used as a thumbs up shooting position if preferred. This is a very short rifle as per the ultras of old, and the maximum length of 820 mm, and it tops the scales at a nice and light manageable weight of just 2.6 kilograms. All of these figures, of course, are without silencer and scope fitted. And they do highlight how this fits nicely into a gun that's going to be easy to manage and carry around and use in tighter confined spaces, such as barns, etc. It really is an ideal pest control tool, really. Now, immediately after saying that, this first edition comes supplied with a BSA 3-9 scope and a single piece mount already fitted, and a really rather quiet BSA silencer to boot. All of which would be just about right in a tight pest control environment, as we've just said. But I couldn't wait to get this and add my personal touches to it. Now, because this is a limited run package, I will be keeping all the supplied extras nice and safely with the gun in the really excellent short hard case. That said, I will be using this for target work and want to test this out at greater distances over time. And I fitted one of my favourite and fastly becoming go-to scopes of mine, especially on shorter guns. It's the 6-24 Veyron first focal plane. It's light, it's compact, and it has terrific optics. Added to this, I just couldn't resist dropping on a sexy-looking Huggett silencer. Not necessarily as quiet as the BSA supplied one, but it looks cool, and when fitted, it adds less length and will still fit nicely in that sturdy hard case. Something sadly you can't do with the BSA one fitted. That one does need to be unscrewed before putting it in the case. It's not a deal breaker, but please remember, as good as the case is, it has an egg box foam finish inside and isn't a cutaway foam or pick and pluck. And as such, if you start swinging the case around or knocking it, the loose silencer inside could knock into your beautifully finished stock. And that would be a disaster, really. So please bear that in mind. I also took the opportunity to fit a set of BKL mounts, which I must admit to being a major fan of. And not only do they center perfectly, as anyone who has used BKLs will agree and vouch for, but they also fit the slightly larger than standard dovetail rail that BSA have used for years. It just neatens everything up nicely. These days, manufacturers all seem to be going down the side lever cocking arm route, and there is nothing wrong with that, but I find it quite refreshing that BSA have stuck with the rear bolt action on this CLX, which is really silky smooth. And I don't know, there's always something traditional and sniper-like about a bolt action gun. Time to explain a thing or two about the CLX and its delay in being launched. You see, BSA had a slight issue with getting supplies of a certain part and had their hand forced, requiring more time to source these parts, which, whilst being a bit of a disappointment to the people keen to get their hands on this little beauty, this time was used wisely by the guys and girls at BSA. In the original design, the technical bods and elves wanted to make an addition to the new gun's design, and they took the opportunity to implement this during the delay period. It is a cocking indicator. This can clearly be seen on the right-hand side of the gun below the magazine slot. This is red if it's cocked and white if it's not. Simple but effective, and another safety feature that most guns would benefit from, in my opinion. Nice one, BSA, and a productive use of that extra time. And don't forget, as owners, we now all benefit from this addition. Worth the wait, if you ask me. The final couple of points to raise is the multi-adjustable trigger that I find suits me so well, and the new 12-round magazine with the usual blue for 177 and red for 22 colour coding. This is also anti-double load and has a countdown indicator window to keep you informed how many shots you have left. Again, a really useful addition to any rifle. Incidentally, you should get between 60 and 70 plus shots out of a fill-up. Okay, so I'm all loaded up and kitted out to my personal preference. Time to put this through the crony and out at the targets. Now, firstly, I loaded this up with 8.44 grain JSBs. Now, I've used quite a few BSAs and Gammos in my time, and they all seem to have a similar trait. And I was keen to see if this was still the same with the CLX. You see, they shoot lovely with 8.44 grain pellets, and they're really accurate with that 315mm cold hammer forge BSA barrel on board, as you'd expect. But they will show lower power levels. This one showed a maximum of 760 feet per second, which equates to a little over 10.8 foot-pounds or 14.7 joules. Now, if however you change the pellets to 10.34 grain, then the BSAs come to life. And even though the feet per second figure falls slightly, as you would expect, the extra weighted pellets really suit these, and the power immediately jumps up to over 11.4 foot-pounds or 15.5 joules. They do seem to like the heavier pellets. I was also keen to see if it likes the Hades 10.34s, because they really do work well in a pest control environment. However, I've found that very odd gun from time to time doesn't like them. It's unusual, but it can happen. Using them in the CLX was, I'm pleased to report, no problem at all. It does like them, and as such will be great if you're taking it out for a spot of pest control. Finally, on the chrono work, I must say I was well impressed with the 3 feet per second spread over a 10-shot run, and that was in both the 8.44 grain and the 10.34 grain tested. Now that's nice and tight. So, all this should be good news for the target work. And it's time to put my latest pride and joy to the test out at 40 metres on quite a fair day. I've done what I can to make me comfortable with it, so now it's all up to the rifle. Now I was really pleased with that. For its first time out and no time really spent to pre-clean the barrel and lead it up beforehand, it was zeroed and then straight to it. With results and grouping like that, I'm going to enjoy my time with this over the coming weeks and months. Now I do realise I've made a few alterations to the original package, but I'm really pleased with the results. Ironically, so are the guys at Vector Air, who have stolen my idea somewhat and put a beach kit together, which should be a little peach. Still, these days it seems I can't keep anything for myself. I must admit, I am very happy with this one and I will definitely be keeping it, and it is likely to be wrapped up in cotton wool to keep this one like new. Well, I was really looking forward to this one and I've really enjoyed it this week. Hopefully you have too. If you have, please give us the old thumbs up, subscribe, don't forget to click the old alarm bell, and while you're at it, take a look at all the forums and sites available. And don't forget the AAR merchandise. Mrs. AAR keeps adding to it to keep it fresh. And the IT guy has designed some new mugs to be available for a short while. Well, that's it from me. I'm just looking for some nice dry days and I'm going to be out and about with this again. For now though, stay safe and shoot safe, and thank you so much for watching. See you next week.